H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Now today we are going to understand verifications. What is meant by verification? What is the purpose of learning Selenium tool? What is the purpose of learning automation testing? Our purpose of learning the automation testing or automation tools, ultimately we want to test the application, right? We are making the process of automating the manual testing. Like, ultimate goal in testing is we have to validate, we have to verify the application. Okay, so our ultimate goal for automation testing or the automation tools is to validate the application. Okay, so far we are understanding how to parameterize, how to synchronize, how to automate different types of objects, how to automate pop-ups, how to automate multiple browsers. But so far we did not discuss about how to validate the application, right? So far we did not discuss about the how to validate the application, but testing versus mainly it's for the validating the application, right? So here verification here, it can be done in two ways. One is by using isDisplayed method. Second one is get text, even there is something like card, get attribute. Here we can validate a particular test case. In a test case, we will have test steps, right? So while automating the test steps, probably these three will be used to validate. Okay, in the test case, we will have a test step, right? While automating the test step is nothing but for each test step, there will be a expected thing, right? I hope everyone knows about the test case, right? You will have a step, you will have expected and actual. Here, step description, I mean what exactly you are doing here. Right. For each step here, you are going to have an expected value. Basically, you are going to have a validation. Right. That can be done using by these three ways. Okay. Now, I'll try to understand here. Now, we'll go for this one, eBay. See here, just observe here, here we have a test case like this, okay, say open ebay.com, okay, this is the step number, say open ebay.com, ebay application, should open. Okay, second step is enter search for an item, basically search for an item. Okay, here set off our results page should be displayed. Okay, I'm saying, you know, once you search for here something here, like say you have vented camera and you have selected some category and you clicked on search. Okay, now I'm saying here results page should be displayed. Okay, so here I want to validate, I have to validate, you know, whether this results has been updated or not. Okay, and then say, if you remember, we were automated this scenario, right? We have opened the eBay, we were successfully opened the eBay and we were searching for an item. But here, if you remember, we did not embed the validations. Okay, we did not validate whether eBay application is open or not, whether results page is displayed or not. Okay, now see here, if you remember, I think we clicked on this daily deals, right? We clicked on daily deals and say the start step. We clicked on this daily deals and we did not validate exactly whether we reached the daily deals page or not, right? Verify daily deals section is displayed. Okay, now actually if you remember, we have automated the same scenario in the during past sessions. Let's see here, this is what we have automated. Okay, now if you observe here, we are opening the eb.com and it seems we are searching for a camera. Okay, and then we are clicking on this daily deals, but we are just following the steps. Basically we have automated these three, like opening a eb.com, searching for an item, clicking the daily deals. It was doing the script, whatever the script that we have developed, it is doing these three operations, but there is no respective logic to validate the application. Okay, so ultimately we want to have the validation, right? It's not like just going navigating through the application. We have to navigate through the application, we should be able to automate navigations like selections and all. At the same time, we should automate the validations too. Okay, now see here, now let me copy this. Okay, so here we are opening the eBay.com. Now here, see here, how can I validate whether eBay application is open or not? Right, here, of course, here we are opening the eBay.com here, but how can I validate whether eBay application is displayed or not? Right, so here, if I can see this text box, say, I go to this eBay.com here. You don't try to understand this point. If I can see this text box, I can conclude that this eBay homepage has been opened, right? If I can see this text box, I can conclude that eBay application has been opened successfully, right? Now see here, so once I click on this eBay.com, okay, here even I know we can have a implicit, right? So this is how now we have been enhancing our scripts. Manage timeout, implicit rate 30, time unit seconds. So here we have configured the browser settings, then we have opened the eBay.com. Now here we are going to validate whether this home page is updated or not. Okay, now browser, find element, see here, I'm just using this particular statement only.
here instead of the clear method, there is something called is displayed. Can you all observe it? Okay, can you all observe it? Is displayed. It means if this object is displayed, basically it is going to say true. Okay, if this object is displayed, here I'm basically now I'm talking about this particular method. If it is displayed, if the object displayed gives true. Okay, if it is not displayed, okay, if it is not displayed, basically it throws no such element exception. Okay, if the object is not presented, it throws no such element exception. Okay, now see here, now if it is there, if it is there, we simply say that system eBay application successfully launched. Okay, in the else condition, basically it will not go for else condition. Okay, here if it throws an error, okay, here basically there is going to be an exception. If this is not going to be successful, this line goes, this line throws an exception. If the object is not presented in the application, okay, it throws an exception. How to handle the exceptions? In how many ways we can handle the exceptions? Any guesses? Yeah, that's correct, Uma. Yes, that's correct, Niranjana. Yes, that's correct, Alga. Yep. Good. Here, yes, now see here I'm using a tri-cache block. So far we have been throwing the exception, but now I'm using tri-cache block here. Okay. I'm keeping this logic in a tri-block. Okay. I'm keeping this logic in a tri-block because it is a risky logic. If the object is not presented, if this object is not presented, it will throw some error. That is the reason I kept this is in it tri-cache block. If you remember, as part of exception, we have discussed this. So in a tri-cache block, we'll basically keep the risky logic. So I kept the risky logic. If this throws an error, okay, instead of throwing that error over the console or instead of stopping the script, basically it will get into catch mode. I'm simply saying exception here. I can specifically mention that no such element found exception also. Okay. See here. Here if the exception is occurred, I can directly say that EB application is not, does not launched successfully. Okay, so this is how we validate. Okay, now here the major role is displayed. Okay, if you want to validate, okay, anything here in the application, there is a method called is displayed. Okay, so how I'm validating once the application is open, if I can see this particular text box, I'm concluding that okay, we reached the EBA application has been opened. Okay, so this is how I can validate. It is one of the way. Is displayed. Okay, and see here. And the next validation here. Now we are successfully validated this. And here search for an item and results page should be displayed. Okay, our next validation is this. I mean, once you enter camera here and once you click on search, you know, here I have to validate a results page should be displayed. Okay. I have to validate whether this result page is displayed or not. Okay. Now here again, now if I can see some results or some this section, okay. If I can see some this section like all listing, options or this results. Okay, if I can see this particular path, I can conclude that we reached the results page, right? So again, spy this page and see the best locative over here. Okay, see here. If I can see this all listing, I can conclude that we reached the results page successfully, or at least if I can see this. See here, I'm just looking at this results. Okay, see here, there is a results header. Can you all agree here? RSHDR. Okay, so if I can see this section, I can conclude that we reached the results page successfully. Again, probably I can use this thread over here. Okay. Here I'm using this RSHDR, and now here once we click on camera, once we click on search button here I'm using the same set of things, and here the locator will be this, and here it is a class RSHDR. So we'll see. Here, apart from ID, there is something like class. I'm using class name. This is a class name. Okay. And here, results page. Results page open. Results page is displayed. Okay. So the other way here I can say results page is not displayed. Okay. And similarly, once we click on daily deals, okay, here our next step is asking verify deals, daily deal section is displayed. So if you can see this section, spy this object and just use this. See here again, probably you can look at this text. Okay, by using this one, XPath. See here, even it is bounded with A tag. Okay, probably you can find using A tag here. Tools, Selenium IDE. 1 minute. Probably we'll use div, because if I use a tag, probably here also this is also a tag, right? Daily deals, this is also a tag. So I'll probably use like this. So you see here I'm building XPath. See here, slash div, and here contains, I'm using dot comma daily deals. Let us say fine. To highlight in the enter section, try to say here instead of dot, we'll say text. Yep, see here it is highlighting daily deals. Okay, probably we can use this locator, and we can again use the same logic. Okay, so of course here in this section, in this particular class, I just used easy split. Okay, yep, we can basically. Sometimes we will come across like using get text. Let me show that also. Let me complete this. Daily deals page is displayed. Okay, so like this we can validate the application. Of course, here in this class, in this particular example, I just used is displayed mainly. Okay, probably we will go with one more example here. The best example is could be here is say here when deal for loans. See here we are clicking on EMA calculator, right? Okay, so once you come here in the EMA calculator, okay, we are feeding some values, like we are entering some 50,000, okay, some interest rate, okay, and then we are clicking on calculate, okay. Say it's like our test step is saying something like this. Say for example, enter loan amount as 50,000, okay, interest rate as say 11, and tenure as say 120, and here in the expected value, say expected EMI is, say for example this one, 6875, okay, expected EMI is this. Now, you know, if you are trying to validate something like this, okay, so here in this case, you have to retrieve some value from the application, okay. In this case, you have to retrieve some value from the application, okay. You are feeding some values, and there is some calculation is happening. So basically, you are not validating whether an object is presented or not, okay. In this case, you are not validating whether an object is displayed in the application or not. You are basically going to retrieve some value, and you have to compare with the expected value, okay. So here actual value means that value have to be retrieved in this automation, have to be retrieved from the application. Actual value is nothing but, actually is nothing but the value which is displayed in the application, right? When I say actual value means whatever it is displayed in the application, this is displayed. So we have to retrieve this value, and we have to compare with this expected value. If both are equal, that we will say pass. Okay, now we'll try to write this scenario here. I'm saying example for is displayed. Now here let me say example for get attribute. Okay, here go browser, new Firefox. So I'm opening a URL over here. I'm opening a browser, and then I'm opening a URL. Okay. Then here we have to click on the CMA calculator, right? So we'll try to find the locator for this. I'm taking the CMA calculator. I think it was not working earlier. We'll see. It seems to be linked text, but I know somehow if you use it, it is not working. Even in Abhijit, I'm saying link equal to EMA calculator. I'm saying fine, but it is not highlighting this EMA calculator here. Okay, somewhere in the background, it seems they have a EMA calculator. Okay, now see, it probably will depend on this href here. So here I'm taking this href. Okay. Now see here, I'm preparing a export for this. @href single quotation. Okay. href, then this. Can you order it? Now this is getting highlighted. Now let me use this export over here. Find element by xpath. Okay, and then we are clicking on it. Okay, after we click on EMA calculator, we are going to enter these three values here. Okay, I'm trying to find this, and it has the ID. So let me take this ID. Browser that find the element by ID. Okay, dot first clear, then send the keys, and here let me say 50,000 here. Okay, now similarly for other two objects, I mean loan tenure, interest rate and tenure. Okay, so we will find the interest rate object. So here it does not have ID, it has name. Okay, so it has name, and here I'm just removing this ID and saying name. And rate of interest is 11. And then let me apply this tenure. And again, it does not have ID and it has name. Okay. Here I'm saying 120 here. Okay. And after that, we have to click on this calculate button. So let me try this calculate button, and here let me try this properly. If it has a name button, so we'll try to take this name. On this, so far we know all these things, right? Now see here, here actually we have to retrieve this value. Okay, we have to retrieve this value, and there will be an expected value. Okay, now see here, here how to retrieve this value. Basically we want to retrieve this value, right? This 199. Okay, this one. Now see here, just observe this object over here. Everyone close the observer here. Just observe this object, and this value 199676. It is a part of this. This is a part of this property called value. We understand in the initial days. Did you remember? This is called as property. This is called as a value, right? Like this value, this 199.67.6. It is a value of this property value. Okay. This is a value of a property called again value. Okay. Now basically I want to retrieve this information. Okay, if I want to retrieve this information, there is something called get attribute. Okay, by using get attribute we can retrieve the information. For example, if I want to know what is the class of this object, I can use get attribute of class. Okay, this we call technically attributes, right? We have discussed. Okay, these are the attributes. If I want to know the any attributes information, I can use get attribute. So first of all, let me take this locator. I'm trying to identify this using page. By name, it's a page. Okay, and here every one of this I'm using get attribute. Okay, I'm using attribute name. Attribute name is this value. Okay, so it is going to retrieve the actual value. Yes, actual EMI. Okay, let me declare this variable. Okay, and now as of now here I'm hard coding. Yes, expected EMI. Okay, let me keep any variable here. What was that value? 68875. Okay. Now, any guesses from anyone? No, in general, where we can keep this data? Here, as of now, I have hard coded it. I have mentioned here itself. In general, where we can mention? Yep, Excel. If you remember yesterday's session, we were discussing about this. We were discussing one of the scenario where what is that? This one, export extension. Okay. If you remember, I said. Here, if you remember, we kept the data here in which bank we want to select, HDFC, Axis, Citibank. Okay, we kept the data in Excel and we were reading the data from the Excel. Okay, we were reading the option. In a similar way, here also, we can keep this expected EMI in the Excel. Basically, this values, this 50,000, 11, 120. So, for these values, against to this, we can say expected EMI. We can read the data from the Excel. Okay. Now this is the expected EMI and here we are getting the actual EMI and we will compare here. Now here our discussion is about this. Okay, this particular method, entire method, why we are discussing to understand this. So there is a method called getAttribute. By using getAttribute, we can retrieve the whatever the property. Say for example, just for example here, see here. Say I want to know even this class, okay, this class information, just for an example. Okay, now we'll try to print this. I'm keeping this logic in a system.println. Okay, now this class information will be printed on the console. Now again here I'm comparing if this expected EMI. Here I can write two ways. Directly I can say expected EMI double equal to S actual EMI, or I can use dot equals. Okay, if both are same, you can say that EMI calculator working as expected. This you can give any information, okay. Else condition. Is not working as expected. Okay. Now if we execute this one, probably in this only we'll try to keep this is displayed also. Okay, say after we clicking on this this EMI calculator here in the home page. Okay, after we clicking on the EMI calculator in the home page, I want to make sure that we reach this successful this page or not. I'm saying we will try to keep this is displayed also here. Okay, so once we click on this EMI calculator here, will make sure that we reach this home page, this page. Okay, so how can I make sure whether we reach this page or not? If I can see this text box, Okay, I can conclude that we reach the EMI calculator page, right? Or if you don't want to use that, you can use this section. You can spy this object and take the locator of this and use this. Okay, so here as of now, I'm just using this one only. Okay, yep, it's get started. I'll wait for the while. Yep, if you remember, you know, as part of the special test cases or special conditions in Selenium, you know, we discussed how to handle auto charges. Did you remember in Gmail, in the Gmail registration page, we entered two or three letters where it was giving a kind of a message saying like a too strong, weak password. Some kind of a feedback was getting up, right? How did we retrieve that? Do you remember? By using get text, we have retrieved that text. So it's like, you know, as part of the validation, say in the test case, it would be like this. Enter two letters and see what is the feedback. Enter four letters, see the what is the feedback. For the two letters, say expected feedback is very weak password. So make sure whether very weak password is showing in the application or not. If you want to retrieve that, you have to use get text. Okay, let it complete. We'll discuss about that. I think it's done. Now see here, let us go to the console and see here. Here EMI calculator page is displayed. EMI calculator is not working as expected. Why it is showing 687? Okay, we'll look into this. Probably know that we'll see what happened over here. 68875, right? Oh. Yeah. Okay, we'll look into this. Okay, and see here. If you observe here, it is showing this input box, input underscore box underscore cal. So it has retrieved this particular property. I was just trying to print this class property, right? So input underscore box underscore cal. Okay, yep. I'm just guessing it's a problem with the synchronization. It means after we're clicking on the button, immediately here this logic is going to retrieve the value. At least there might be at least a fraction of a second will be there, right? So basically Selenium tool is very fast. So let me keep a wait over here. So let me use 2000 over here. I mean, it means that's two seconds I'm making the tool to wait. Okay. Now see here, I did not include any other things. I just used over here. Now let us try to execute. Because after we clicking on submit button, after we clicking on calculate button, it is giving the output. Probably it will take at least a fraction of a second, right? But Selenium basically it is a very fast tool. It will not wait even a fraction of a second. Here, once it clicked on calculate button, now we'll go here, look at this output. Still it is saying not working. First of all, we'll try to print. See here, now it is a process of like debugging. We prepared the script, now we are trying to dig into the issue. So here, first of all, we'll try to print what is the value it contained. Okay, so let me say system dot out dot println. No. Okay. Okay, I'm printing whatever the value it is getting up. Okay. Now probably we'll use dot equals instead of this. Okay, it seems see here. EMI calculator page is displayed 6.8875. EMI calculator is working as expected. It seems, you know, it's the problem with this string comparison here. Basically, when we say double equal, it should compare. Okay, probably it is not comparing exactly. Okay. So, however, I have used string-based equals here. Okay. So here the main thing is this one: get attribute. By using get attribute, we can retrieve the property we can retrieve the property or attributes value. Okay, so required attributes value. So this is one of the good example here where we are retrieving this value. Okay, now what I was talking about, this one, a special case, as part of special cases here, if you remember, we discussed about auto suggestions. Yep, here auto suggest, and where, you know, we were executing this script, okay, and here we were getting the password rating get text. We are retrieving the text and basically we are printing here, right? Say here our test case is saying that, so enter, say for example, enter A, B, okay, as it is a two characters only, say expected is like, say it is expected message is valid, verify this one, two short message, okay, verify two short message should be displayed, something like this. Okay, so you have to, what you have to do, you have to retrieve this text. How you are retrieving the text? By using get text. By using get text, we are retrieving the text, and then here we'll write a if else condition with the expected value. Okay, so get text is going to retrieve the text from the application. Okay, get attribute, which will help us in retrieving the value. Okay, so this is how we will write the validations in our scripts. Okay, in Selenium, this is how we write the validations. So whatever we have been discussing, like, I know here I'm using some methods, I'm using if else conditions, right? Now apart from this, there is something else. See here, here there is something like JUnit methods here. Let me give a brief idea over here. Now if you go to this verifications, now see here, JUnit verifications are like this. There will be like assert. Assert is a part of JUnit. Okay. Now see here, I can say assert equals. Here I can mention, everyone observe here, assert. There is something called assert. It is a part of JUnit, and there is something like assert equals. Here you will mention expected value and actual value. Here in this case, for example, if you want to use this assertion. Now see here, instead of this place, say here we have expected and actual value, right? Say for example, if we keep this assertion equals, say this expected EMI and say actual EMI, okay, if we keep over here, okay, why it is showing like this, 1 minute. Let me write this. Yep. Well, it is getting strike out. It seems I know it seems recently it has been outdated. Okay, this assert is been outdated. Basically, you know, it's kind of what we can say. If you don't use this, I mean, not if you don't. There will be like outdated, like this, it seems this assertion is like outdated, it seems. Earlier it was not there, recently, now, I mean, in this class only it is coming up. In the earlier batches it did not appear, we did not face this. Okay, see here, can you all observe here, there is something like deprecated. Can you all observe that word over there, deprecated. Deprecated means nowadays it's been outdated, okay. In the earlier version, I mean, in the batch before we had, I know there it was working.
It seems that from the last 1 month it has been, you know, make it as outdated. Of course, it has to be because, you know, see here, the in generally it provides assertions. Okay, now see here, everyone observe here, assert dot assert equals, and here we have this value. Basically, if this condition passes, it will continue the execution. Everyone observe here. If the highlighted line is passed, it is going to continue the execution. If the highlighted line is not going to pass, it will stop the script. One thing, and moreover, here there won't be a proper output will not be shown here. Just assertions, basically this assertion JNet methods, this assertions is mainly for the Java developers for their unit testing purpose. Okay. In unit testing level, they don't need to give the feedback. I mean, they don't need to give the output. Here we have been giving the output here, right? Here we are generating an output file here. We are printing some output here. But here in this case, for the Java developers, they basically don't need any output. Just they want to make sure that their Java logic is working perfectly, is working properly or not. So at that time, they don't require any output messages. But for a functional automation testing, we need the messages. We have to know whether what is passed, what is not failed, what is not passed. Okay. For a functional automation, we need the output messages. Whereas the JNet, JNet methods will not have the output messages. Here we have mentioned output message, but it is not going to be printed over here. Okay. The CMA calculator working as expected. It is not going to be printed. And moreover, if it is passed only, probably it is going to be shown this message somewhere. But if it is failed, it is not going to show any message. I mean to say here, these are related to JNet methods. Okay. These are related to JNet methods. If you use these things, there won't be any proper output. Okay, we cannot see any proper output. Okay, for a functional automation tester, generally we will not depend on the JNet related or test engine related methods over here. Okay, see here, I'm saying assert, probably let me take this JNet. Okay, let me go here, since this framework I have removed, let me take from one minute where you have used org.jnet. Okay, instead of jnet, let me say org.jnet. Okay, this assert is different. Okay, got it. Now the earlier assert that we were using, it's a part of a old thing. Okay, it seems. Now let me remove this. Oh, even this also seems outdated. Earlier, in the previous case, we have used the JNet framework. Okay, we were using this assert. Okay, assert from this JNet framework. Okay, basically org.jnet is the nowadays we are using org.jnet. Okay. So, however, even it has been outdated. Here, if you all observe here, there is something like assert equals, assert array equals. So, here in the array itself, these people are compiling a lot of things. Okay. And here, assert equals, and here there is something like long expected, long actual. It means if you want to compare two long based, if you remember, I said as part of data types, okay, we understand integer, right? Okay. In integer itself, I said there will be like short, long. So long is one type of data type as part of integer. Okay, even double. Okay, if it's just comparing. Okay, if you observe here, it is just comparing here, and it will not give any proper message output. Okay, if it fails, it won't give any message. If it passes, it won't give any message, and if it fails, basically it may give a message. Okay, and mainly JNet this one. Okay, this JNet related things will be generally used for the this one.
mainly for the Java developers. Okay, these are the JNN methods, basically, which is for the verifications. Okay, JNN methods. When I say JNN methods, means these are for the verifications. But however, these verifications, may this JNN verifications, it's only for the developers. Okay.
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.